Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Far Show Live. As you can see, we're filming the show tonight, so give it all you've got. Let yourselves go and enjoy yourselves. The show's going to be exactly the same as usual. However, in order to make sure that we get a PG certificate for the video, I'm afraid we've had to cut out all the swearing.
Oh, fuck. Sorry, booger. What about this bunch of ladyboys here? Do you want it, sir, madam, sirs?
Ooh. Hey! Just have a sit there, mate.
Does my bum look big in this?
It's gripped, it's sorted, let's off-road.
You ain't seen me, right?
You ain't seen me neither, right?
Blimey, this is dragging on a bit, isn't it? Anyone fancy a pint?
Told you, mate, come and sit in here.
Don't make me come down there and liven you up. Yeah, are you all right? Now, my name is Billy Bleach. I'm 39 years old. I live at home with my mum, Rose Bleach. She's 82. She's lovely. Wears a lot of pastel, you know. She's a lot of mum to me. Now, that's a joke. Timing, isn't it? And material. Yeah. Now, the other day, I've gone shopping in the West End, right, and I've noticed how male cosmetics have come on a bundle since I was a nipper. When I was young, you had soap, and that done for everything. These days, there's all kinds of gear for fellas, isn't there? You can get anti-wrinkle cream for your arsehole. Cellulite powder for your knees. And all those mad shampoo flavours. Elderflower and parmesan. Peach, fennel and creosote. And I thought to myself, I'm not going down to the pub tonight. I'm going to stay in and have a right lovely bath. And I bought myself some right tasty bath oil. It was called Kum Kai bath oil. £9 it was. But hey, I think I'm worth it. Indoors, right, put the taps on. And they've put a story on the label of the bath oil for you to read. Why are you having a wash? What a result, right? And this is what it said on the label, yeah? On my life, right? Kum Kai bath oil. Here at Petrochemical Holdings, we have blended the subtle spices of the Orient with fresh herbs from the tropical rainforest to bring you Kum Kai bath oil. Hi-ya! From the angry markets of Marrakesh to the steaming jungles of the Congo, we have harnessed ungovernable nature to bring you Kum Kai bath oil. Ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay Veal cum kai, subtle oils, wash around your old ball bag. To Mexico, to the high plains, where we collected fresh dew and jujube berries. On the way back, we see a couple of Mexicans get shot. But we was in a rush and we didn't want to interfere. Pour two capfuls into hot running, well, you know that. And there's a new range for men, Acne bath products for geezers. And on the bath oil, it says, "What's wrong with soap, you cunt?"
Beautiful. Smooth as silk.
Hello, sir. You're young, aren't you, sir? You're Game Boy age, aren't you, sir? Oh, I can picture you now, sir, tucked up in bed, all cross-eyed, furiously manipulating your Game Boy, sir. Ooh.
Don't be ridiculous, Ken. He'll have both hands on his PlayStation.
Ooh,
suit you. Xbox you, sir.
Well, actually, I'm more likely to be on the internet.
Help me up, Kenneth. Are you on it a lot, sir?
Bet you're on it night and day, aren't you, sir?
Look, I'm looking for a suit right now. What kind of styles have you got?
Well, we have two-piece, three-piece, flannel, mohair, wool mix, single-breasted, double-breasted, sir.
Oh. They're all called Candy and Mandy, aren't they, sir?
Who?
The girls on the internet, sir.
Mm.
They're often of Eastern European extraction, aren't they, sir? Does your heart go out to them, sir? Do you feel sorry for them, sir? Part of the sad tide of human misery that abounds since the demise of the old Soviet bloc. Do you really feel for them, sir?
Or do you just think sod it and reach for the Kleenex?
Look, about this soup, right?
Soup, sir? We don't sell soup.
Soup you, sir? That'd be ridiculous. No, sir, I think you'll find that we're in the business of gentlemen's tailoring. Long legs, short sleeved, high waist, low waist, broadband.
Broadband, Asian babes, pony girls, barely legal. Ooh, we're back on the net, aren't we, sir?
Thumbnails, sir.
Ooh, thumbnails.
Thumbnails,
Kenneth.
Little pictures, they promise you the earth, don't they, sir? Before you impatiently shoot off onto the next site.
But eventually, sir, can't resist.
Click.
Enlarge.
Click.
Enlarge.
Click, click, click.
Repeatedly clicking on enlarge to make it bigger.
Bigger, bigger, bigger.
Click.
Bigger.
Click.
Bigger.
Click.
Bigger.
Click, click, click.
Bigger, bigger, bigger.
Oh, we've lost him, Kenneth.
Lost our playmate, Ken. Not to worry, plenty more fish in the sea.
Yes, at least he's still alive. And not at the bottom of a swimming pool with his arse in tatters.
Choo-choo, sir.
Shall we set up here, Johnny?
Yes, this is a lovely spot, isn't it, darling?
Righto. I've brought some lunch, a lovely quiche, homemade, of course, and some olives, green olives.
It's very thoughtful, darling. Oh, now I shall have to get the pale blue out for the sky and some green for the lovely rolling hills. And look. There's a vicar going past on his bicycle. Yes, I shall need some white for his collar. Then I shall need the... Oh, he's gone.
Ah, that's a relief.
It is a relief, darling. Yes, I've never been very good at drawing bicycles.
No, Johnny, you wouldn't have wanted to put him in anyway. It would have been completely the wrong mood.
I think you're right. I shall stick to the wildlife, the birds and the bees and... Look, there's a jolly little magpie over there. Yes, I shall need some white.
Hello, Mr. Magpie. Where's Mrs. Magpie?
You scared him away, dear.
Oh, really?
Never mind. Look, there's a crow.
Oh!
Oh, and a raven. Oh. And a whole flock of rooks.
Shh.
Really, dear, whatever's got into you? You're behaving like a lunatic. There shan't be a bird around here for 100 miles.
Look, Johnny, will you forget about the wretched birds, please? Why don't you look at... that lovely old aeroplane up there.
Oh, yes, you know, I do believe that's a Spitfire, darling. Must be an air show on round here somewhere. Takes me right back to my childhood. Do you remember? Battle of Britain.
Oh, yes. The menace of Hitler. The spectre of fascism. Winston Churchill. Vera Lynn on the radio. The Blitz. The blackout.
You're right. I shall have to get the blackout.
No, you won't, dear.
Yes, I will. For the SS uniforms, darling. And for the swastikas. Black, 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 all black. Black, black. Like the black eyes of the panda. Spying on me through the black bamboo. Black, 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 like a rotten banana. Riding a tiny little motorcycle. Right through the Queen Mother's rotten black teeth. Black, black, black. Like the burnt bits you occasionally get in a bowl of Frosties. What have you done with Father, Mother? Folded him like a ticket and poked him in a hole. Black, 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 black. Move it, move it, move it, move it, move it. Black, like the black ducks of despair, quacking their endless litany. Quacking their endless litany of death and pain. Quack. Quack. Quack.
I think it's time we went home now, Johnny.
Quack.
Nobody
quack.
Wants to see your old bottom.
Quack, quack. Quack, 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 quack.
Come along, Toby. Stop dawdling. Well, here we are, lad. Your first visit to a public house. 18 years old, eh? Where have the years gone to? I barely recognise you, lad. You're like a completely different actor. Come along. Now, it's very important you learn to hold your drink from a young age. That is why I'm here to look after you, your father, the patriarch.
Yeah, but I don't want to get drunk, Dad. I'll miss Malcolm in the middle.
Will you be quiet? Can barely hear myself think. Now, landlord. Oh, it's a tart. As it's autumn, we'll have 2 pints of local bitter, please.
Dad, can't we go somewhere fun? Like to some kind of lap dancing joint or something?
Certainly not. When you are 21, I will avail you the services of a prostitute. But just bear in mind, I will be in the same room offering practical instruction. Well, here we are, Toby. A toast to manhood. Now, don't rush him. Respect it. And respect yourself. Now, down in one! You cheat! Silence! You know, Toby, drinking this bitter reminds me of a hostelry I used to frequent in Surrey, the Three Tuns. There was a barmaid there with slim hips, slimmer than your mother. At night, the men would be all over like Albanians round a container lorry.
You shouldn't say things like that, Dad. I love Mum.
I love your mother too, Toby, but a father's love and a son's love are two very different things. Your love looks up to her, whereas mine looks down on her. Well, cheers, Toby. This is good fun, isn't it? Soon we'll play some games.
Oh, good. Can we play pool or pinball or something?
Don't be so childish. No, we'll have a running race. We'll sprint from this inn, out of the door, down the road and back, and the loser will buy the next round. So get down in Olympic positions. Come on your marks.
Yes.
Olympic, Toby, not Commonwealth. Olympic positions. Move your hands forward. Pay attention. Right. I have no weapon, so I'll just start with my voice. Ready? Go.
Turned out
shite again. Honey came in and she called me red-handed, freaking with the girl next door. Picture this, we were both butt-naked, banging on the bathroom floor. Forget that I had given her an extra key. All the time she was standing there, she never took her eyes off me. But she got me on the counter. It wasn't me. We were shagging in the shower. It wasn't me. I even had it on the sofa. It wasn't me. She even got me on the camera. It wasn't me. Do you really like it? Is it wicked? We're loving it, loving it, loving it. We're loving it like this. Do you really like it? Is it wicked? We're loving it, loving it, loving it. We're loving it like that. You sexy motherfucker.
Yes, the unmistakable sound of whistling Fred Halibut means that it's that time again. Live from the BBC Radio Theatre in London, it's the Arthur Atkinson Radio Show. Starring the natty dresser with the golden patter, the nutty golfer with the golden putter, the nifty potter with the priceless potty.
Get on with it, you pompous old windbag.
It's Arthur Atkinson.
Aye. Have you seen it? Aye, have you seen it? Have you had it? Where's me washboard? Hey, how queer. Here, look at this. See, I've got another one on the other side, look. Have that. Here, yes, no. Here, yes, oi, oh, no, yes, here. Hey, I could go on all night. Here, no, yes, here. No, yes. Just, no. Here, look, I made myself laugh there. Now, you see? That's never happened before. Yes, here. What are you laughing at, madam? Yes, you over there, the large lady. Yes. I've seen you bobbing up and down in a jar like a little banana. No. Yes. And what about you, sir? Yes, you know what I'm talking about. Who do you think you are? Uncle Tumbly, the tumbling Turk? Hey? You know what I'm talking about, even if I don't. Yes. Here. No. And what about you, sir? I've seen you bottling anthrax when it should have been mustard gas. Yes. All right, we're going to have some fun now, ladies and gentlemen, so it's on with the show.
Yes, welcome to the Arthur Atkinson Radio Show with me, Anthony Radford Cooper, and Miss Kitty Hudson.
Hello.
This week, it's a lovely day, and Arthur finds himself in hospital in Cardiff wearing a neck brace.
Yeah, I've only gone down on Shirley Bassey, haven't I? Yes. And I've got whiplash when she came.
Who, Arthur?
Yes. Yes, Doctor, can you do anything for me? Honey, I'm feeling like I've lost three bob and found some fish and chinkles.
Oh, Arthur.
What are your symptoms, Mr. Atkinson?
Well, I've got water on one knee, a housemaid on the other, and whiskey on me breath.
Oh, Arthur.
You're incorrigible.
Is it serious?
No, it's humorous.
Paul Gould, will I still be able to play the fool?
Yes, to simply take five of these pills twice a day, 3 at 12 and 2 at 2.
12 at 2 and 2 at 3?
No, 2 at 2.
2 at 2?
Yes, 2 at 2.
Oh, blimey, is there an owl in here? Quick, nurse, take me temperature.
Oh, Arthur.
Yes, I've got it. Later in the day, Arthur goes for a recuperative picnic in lovely Splot. With an inappropriately young girl.
Yeah, all right, stick to the script.
Who is, in fact, his niece.
All right, I'm only new, Mr. Cooper.
And you know she's 3 years younger than it says in her contract.
Yeah, I'll do the jokes.
Yes, that'll be a first.
Oh, well, isn't this lovely?
Oh, it's lovely, Arthur.
Yes. I'll tell you what, why don't we have some sandwiches? I'll cut them, you spread them.
Oh, Arthur, I shall wet myself.
Really? Here, have a look at this, look. Hey, look at that. Yes. Don't worry, folks, it's only radio.
Oh, Arthur, I really shall wet myself.
Mm.
Oh, the one that I love loves me. Oh, oh, ah, ah, ee. I'm as happy as I can be, 'cause the one that I love loves me. Am I buying a bungalow? Ee, ee, ha, ha, ho, ho. Where the money is, I don't know. Still, I'm buying a bungalow. She's habeas corpus. I've heard that word before. She's vice versa. And when you're that, you can't be anymore.
Arthur Atkinson there, and Arthur is an all-rounder. Singer, songwriter, dancer, electrician. My name's Tommy Cockles, and here's a joke I got from Ray Reardon, the popular snooker player and witch doctor. Many years ago, there were two brave explorers travelling through a hot jungle, Leonard and Peter. It was terrible. Huge vines, unfamiliar shrubs, insects, wild animals, lions, tigers, beavers, crows. Presently, they arrived at a wonderful clearing with some flat turf and a little pool, and Leonard, he said, "Right, Peter, we'll make camp here, we'll put up the tent, we shall make a fire, I've got some potatoes in my bag, I'll make some chips, you go back into the jungle and catch a pig, and we'll have suckling pig and chips for our tea." And Peter was very pleased, and off he went into the jungle, you know. He took a book with him, Pigs of the Jungle. He wouldn't want to get a poisonous one, you know. Meanwhile, Leonard, our hero, well, his hands were a blur. He made a wonderful fire in a little circle and a bowl out of nothing, and he carved this wonderful ornate spit with Queen Victoria's face on one end and Dixie Dean's on the other. And he awaited the return of his friend. Well, Peter soon returned. Not with a pig, with a pygmy! Leonard was furious. He said, "No, Peter, no. I said a pig, not a pygmy. We can't eat him. He's a human man." And Peter said, "Well, I tried to catch the pigs. They ran here and there. A group of them hid behind a tree and laughed at me." This fella came quietly. And Leonard said, "Right. We'll have to eat him, but they're a bugger to cook. I've eaten one of these before, during the war, in Croydon. Get him on that spit and turn him for about 4 hours at fire mark 5. I'll go back into the jungle and collect some fruit and make a fruit compote." I went to Marks and Spencer's today. Off he went, back into the jungle. He took a book with him, you know, Fruits of the Forest. He wouldn't want to get a poisonous one. And when he returned, he found his chum spinning the pygmy ever so fast, like a human Catherine wheel. He said, "No, Peter, no, I said turn him slow, turn him slow." He went, "I know, I did that," but he kept nicking the chips.
This week, I have been mostly wondering how come I'm 3.5 months pregnant.
Boutros, Boutros, Gali.
Mantinato, ton Channel 9, te program musical Angleterre, Jazz Club. Nice.
Kofi Annan. Presentare previoso, Louis Balfour, Trinky Drivey, Smashy Halsey in the Priory. Wanker. Chris Waddle. Smicky pinky bang bang, Alimentado Reggae Bones, right? Falia hela, don dance troupe Canadia Jazz Experimentalis Thrusk, really nice, great!
I can't help you!
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm just going to take a few short minutes of your most valuable time to introduce you to my fabulous new range of celebrity perfumes. In the foyer, after the show, you'll find a couple of my hand-selected representatives offering choice samples of these perfumes. Now, the one for the ladies has been lovingly and specifically created with the older lady in mind. Might be of some interest to you, my dear. No offence. It's Elizabeth Taylor's Hot Flush. Now, for the gents, I'm sorry, I see something in the audience here that requires my immediate attention. It's you, Pet. My God, you're quite a fright, aren't you? Right, well, I think you could benefit from a tip from an internationally renowned makeup artist such as myself, yeah? Proper application of a good basic makeup is absolutely essential for any lady who's desperate to get married. And let's face it, you're very much in that territory, aren't you? No offense. The kind of makeup I'm talking about, of course, is the sort of makeup I have on. I'm sure most of you can't even tell I'm wearing any. You see, it's very subtle, but it's enhancing my natural beauty, yeah? Actually, do you know what? I think all you girls here of Cardiff would do well to take the tip that I gave that poor unfortunate creature on board. And do you know why? I was doing some shopping today down your high street, and I can tell you, you are mingers. No offense. But actually, the girls in the audience that I'm really talking to are those of you who are unfortunate enough to have children and yet be unmarried. You know, it's not just me. Nobody wants soiled goods. No offense. Do you know what? I think it's fair to say that in today's modern society, an unmarried mother may as well be a leper. No offense, girls. Now, for the gents, I did have two products on offer, but sadly, I've had to withdraw one of them. It was You Know You Want It by John Leslie. Well, it turns out you didn't want it at all. No offense, John. I do, however, have a really very exciting brand new product, Pour Homme's, and that's Angus Deaton's Crotch. It's a fantastically powerful and yet also somehow slightly disturbing odour. It's also really very now. I mean, let's face it, who hasn't had a splash of that recently? And should you decide to make a purchase, I'm also throwing in, for absolutely no extra money, Angus's Crotch on a Rope. And that's marvellous, because it means you get the smell of Angus's crotch all day long. That's free. It's gratis. No money will change hands. And I'm guessing that that's going to be of particular interest to you, sir. Yes, I don't know why, but there's something about you that strikes me as really penny-pinching, mean, tight-fisted type of a person. No offence. And for your friend, I have the perfect penile enhancement cream. No offence.
Enjoying the show. We are.
Lovely.
Yes, we just bought a couple of programmes and a T-shirt for Peter and Marjorie, and we thought, let's have a lovely shag.
Oh, lovely. Oh,
me.
The women here in a box in the theatre with a shagging couple. With my reputation. Are they quite mad? I don't discriminate, you know. Oh, well, brace yourselves. I'm coming in dry.
Never mind, lad. 20 press-ups, please, and mind your posture. Happy birthday. Toby, you oaf. Cease. Stop. Stand up. Watch me. And learn. You ready?
You just did one, Dad.
Yes, Toby, but it was technically perfect. Come on, Toby, it's your birthday. You should be having fun. Come on, let's play some games. I'm getting quite drunk now, all this hot air and running around and booze. I'll sing some of your favourite songs and you join in, yes? Come on, let me think. I'm living in a box. I'm living in a cardboard box. Snooker, loo, peanuts are we, him and you and him and me. Oh, you really are a dead loss, Toby. I'm doing everything in my power to grant you a wonderful birthday and you shun it. I know. Your old favourite. Why don't you fight me? Come on, fight your old dad. Wrestle me. Sumo, any style.
Have you seen yourself? Oh.
I'm very sorry, Toby. It's the air and the beer. I'm a little drunk. Hold me.
Come on, Dad, I'll take you home.
I think I'm going to be sick. I love you, Toby, but I'm not your father.
I can't find my seat. I'm not pissed, I just can't find my... Darling. Darling, I can't find my seat. God, it's hopeless in here.
It's a little railway. Look, it's a bar.
I'm not pissing it.
Hello.
You smell nice. Oh, dear. It's a pint. And he hasn't got any friends or anybody to look after him. I'm not pissed, you know. I just can't find my seat. Darling! Darling! I'm lost again. And I'm in this fucking huge auditorium.
Hold on to your wallets. Ah. Damn it.
Oh. Oh, look, he's dropped some dosh. What am I going to do? Sorry?
Oh, you low-life scum. I didn't realise we're in fucking Liverpool. Excuse me, mate. You just dropped this.
Oh. Thanks.
Yeah, no, you can't be too careful these days, can you? You know what I mean? There's a lot of dodgy geezers around, isn't there? Yeah? Sometimes I despair of the human race. I really do.
Well, I don't despair when there's people like you around.
Yeah, you wouldn't want to meet me a couple of years ago, mate. I'd have had that dosh away. I'd probably need your wallet, your watch, your mobile, your motor, and your bird, yeah. I was a terror. I was a one-man crime wave. I was worse than him. I was a little bit whir, a little bit wee, a little bit shh. I was dodgy. I was a geezer. Right? Not anymore, though. No. On my last two stretch, I've only found God, haven't I? Jehovah, the Lord, the light, the one true path. I forgive you. Yeah, I've nicked a Bible off the chaplain, right, and it's changed my life. Yeah. Don't get me wrong, though, I'm still one of the top boys, do you know what I mean? It don't say nowhere in the Bible, thou shalt not be a little bit wee. Thou shalt not be a little bit wee. Obviously, I've had to lay off the shh, do you know what I mean? No, these days, I'm more kind of, let us pray. Would you like to pray with me?
Well, I don't really,
Well, you might find it helps, you know, just kneel down, close your eyes, you know. I'll hold your jacket. Go on. Go on, our father and all that. Go on. Sometimes it's just too easy, do you know what I mean? Come on, girl.
And I just removed one of Paul Burrell's testicles for the Prince's Trust. And I was making my way back to the car when I heard footsteps behind me. And I was rugby tackled by Ashanti, Samantha Mumba, Nelly Furtado, and Miss Dynamite Tee-hee, who told me that I'd won Rear of the Year, which was nice.
There was the humble pea. Then there was cheese. Hello, peas. Hello, cheese. Oh, dear. They don't want to have anything to do with each other.
Oi, put a sock in it, mate. I'll sort this out. Do you like cheese? Do you like peas? Come on, then. Let's get it together with cheesy peas. The Cheesy Peas dancers. Do you want to see some more? No? Oh, all right.
Ah, yucky da, Paul.
Yucky da, Swiss.
How does the world find you this morning?
Not bad, not bad. Listen, do you mind if I take the afternoon off? It's just that I've got to go to the dentist, you see.
Yes, I don't see why not.
Oh, I was kind of hoping you'd say no. I hate the dentist. I don't know how anyone could be a dentist.
I don't know, Paul. I should think that being a dentist is very much like making love to a beautiful woman. You see, women and teeth are very similar. These days, pulling one is so much simpler than it ever used to be. Things were very different in my grandfather's time. I remember him telling me that he used to have to tie a piece of string around his attached to the door and slam it. It wasn't bear thinking about. One day he pulled the knob clean off. No, these days you just play them some soft music to calm their nerves and lull them into a false sense of security. Strap them down into a chair, shine a bright light into their eyes to bewilder them, pump them full of drugs and whip a drill bit out. Yes, and you should see the look on their faces when it starts to revolve. And Paul, get her to open wide and probe her cavities with your tool. You might like to use a mirror so that you can watch yourself while you're doing it. Then you need to get stuck in and drill away until you're right down into a root canal. Yes, and don't be put off by that high-pitched whining noise and slight smell of burning. Finally, Paul, she'll want to swill and spit. And if it's gone soft, you'll have to pull it out and start again.
Right, I'll remember that, Swiss.
Yes, mark it well. You know, I think I might just take the afternoon off as well myself.
Oh, yeah?
Yes, taking a round or two of golf.
Oh, golf? I've never played that before. What's it like?
You know, Paul, giving it some very, very careful consideration, viewing it from every angle and weighing it up and deliberating over it for some time, I think you'll find that playing golf is very much
like making love to a beautiful woman.
That's a very good analogy. You know, I hadn't thought of that. Yeah. Funnily enough, playing golf is very much like making love to a beautiful woman. First of all, clean your balls so that they move freely through the air. Then, before you take aim for the hole, check for any excess wind, any water hazards, and any dense undergrowth that might trap your balls. Finally, Paul, finally, take a good firm grip on your putter. Take a good firm grip. I do beg your pardon, madam, I nearly took your eye out there. Take a good, firm grip on your putter, Paul. And if there's any rough beyond the hole, make sure you don't overshoot.
Thank you very much. Peace in the valley. Good evening. My name's Clive Graham, and I'm here with the usual suspects, Tommy Steen and Uncle Ron Manager.
Uh-huh.
Well, Ron, it's wonderful to be in Cardiff with Welsh football truly in the ascendancy.
Oh, you know, isn't it? The soccer dragon breathes again, doesn't it? Albeit with a hint of coal dust and heroin, you know, but...
Tommy Steen, I understand you do some scouting.
Absolutely.
Have you had a chance to go to Swansea?
Nah, fuck 'em.
Now then, Ron, enough of that, please. Cast your mind back, if you would, to the summer. Forget Penmania, the false dawn, and the World Cup.
Oh, that was a World Cup that wasn't, isn't it? Wasn't it? Was, wasn't it? I don't know, you know. Marvellous, though, isn't it? You know, hundreds of tiny yellow men scurrying about at breakneck speed after the ball. A pitch on wheels, you know. Dogs for dinner, hmm? Oh, you know. Soccer at 6 a.m. and John Watson in a turmoil over his sausages.
Aye. But great to see Brazil back up there where they belong.
Oh, Brazil, the silky skills.
Samba football.
Small boys on the beach, isn't it, you know? Hmm? Thongs for goalposts. Oh. A bare-breasted lovely watching, you know. Hang on a minute. She's got a penis.
That's for great players, Ron.
Oh, legendary names, isn't it? You know, Garrincha, Tostão, Pelé. I'm impotent!
Are you?
Yes, I am.
Yes, I think it's fairly safe to say we're all seedless in this box.
We are, and it's something I talk freely about in my new autobiography.
Oh, God, spare us the plug for your book, man.
No, I shan't. It's on sale now, and it really lifts the lid on soccer. It makes Roy Keane's book look like the work of a prawn sandwich-eating, shirt-lifting Irish arse bandit.
Look out, Ron, he's behind you!
No, don't worry, Ron. He rarely crosses the bridge, but be careful, because he is clinically insane. Now then, Tommy, the European Championships 2 years hence, a good chance for Sven's men.
Oh, Sven's men, don't make me laugh. No talent, no imagination, no chance.
2 words for you, Jocko. Pharaoh.
Isles.
And 3 words for you. Ulrika fucking Johnson.
One, two, one, two, sisters. No, I need my fallback in. One, two, one, two, sisters. Right, that's where you two come in, and don't fuck it up again like you did last night. Oh, yeah, that was pitiful.
I'm sorry, I've been a bit distracted. I've broken up with my boyfriend.
Like I give a shit. I am that interested in your personal life, and yours for that matter. Bloody hell, I don't pay you to listen to your problems. Christ, I don't think Whitney need a boyfriend for anyway. They are so last year. All right, hit it. Piss. What the fuck you two are up to, I don't know. Bloody hell. And who set the mic up? A bloody monkey or what? Can you get someone up here now to sort it out? And I do mean now.
Sorry, I'm sorry.
Oh, hello! Oh, what does that do? Oh, hi, you're really big and strong. Hi. Those two are being really horrible to me. They're not being my friends. They don't think boys are important, and I think boys are the most important thing in the whole world. Would you like to be my boyfriend?
Maybe.
Sometimes it's hard to be a woman. We can't even do really difficult things like driving. Giving all your love to just one man, because that's what I do. You know, you'd be the only one. You'd be the first. Oh, you'll have bad times, and he'll have good times. Do you want to see my bosoms doing things that you don't understand? Oh, that is huge! I'll let you fat me up to bum.
How you doing? Dave Angel, eco-warrior, live the dream. But what is a dream? My own personal dream is a brand new world with no pollution, responsible redistribution of wealth in the third world, and nudism properly recognised by the British government. Hey, let it all hang out. Now, I've been lobbying Tony Blair. When I say lobbying, I don't mean raising questions in the Houses of Parliament. I mean throwing lumps of wood over the wall at Chequers. Unfortunately, I've caught Cherie on the side of the head and she's gone over. I felt terrible. Let's face it, she's already had a couple of knocks with the ugly stick already. Now, as you know, I am totally eco-friendly and I cycle to and from these concerts on a bike made specially out of tofu and licorice. It's a wonderful way of life. I wave to the birds in the sky and I nod to the beasts of the field. But as I was coming here today, this Range Rover's come tearing past me on the right-hand side and there were two kiddies in the back throwing wine gums out onto the road. Now, if there's any children in, please, these chewy sweets, like Frutellas and Jelly Tots, can be very dangerous. When thrown from a moving vehicle, they hit the road. The sun beats down on them, warms them up, and they become tacky. Along comes Mr. Squirrel, minding his own business. Aye, aye, he's got his feet caught. Whoosh, he's flat as a pancake. Gee, please. I'm only trying to save lives. A strawberry starburst can choke a badger to death. Now, next Friday, I'm holding a nude seminar at my ranch in Chigwell. Come one, come all, leave your clothes at the door, we'll burn them, and spend the weekend with me and my wife stark bollock naked. Hey, it'll be a great party, we'll have some mulled wine, maybe some fireworks. About 5:30, I cock my leg up on a back fence and the wind blows right up my light and bitter. I'm like a human wind chime. After Shirley's done the washing up, she pops out and joins me, and we do the songs of Don McLean. Vincent, whatever you like. I'll see you Friday. Ta-da.
Hello there. Bob Fleming here. Excuse me. Now tonight, with the help of a couple of my friends, I'd like to play for you. I'd like to sing for you some of my favourite folk. My favourite folk. I'd like to sing for you my favourite folk. 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 Oh, folk, folk, folking folk songs. Oh, that's got it. Now, I don't know if some of you may have noticed, but occasionally in the past, I've suffered from a slight tickle in the old throat. But as you can see, that's completely cleared up now. Thanks to the administrations of my Chinese herbalist doctor friend, Doctor. Woo! I do beg your pardon. Doctor. Woo! Woo! I'm sorry. Dr. Arhar Arwahuahar. And he sorted it right out.
Hockey 1, 2, 3, Roberto, here we come, ready or not.
Can hear? Give him a big hand, ladies and gentlemen. Here we are. My young friends, Clyde Thomas and Jeb Taylor. Come on down, boys.
That's right. Now then, Robert, this is great news. about this Chinese fella sorting out your cough.
Huck is you!
All right.
There's nothing wrong with me.
All right. Oh. You ready, are you?
I'm always ready, me.
Oi.
Ready when you are, boy.
Yes, well, let's crack on, eh? Music, maestro, please.
Are you going to Scarborough Fair? Parsley, sage, rosemary, and achter!
Froggy went a courtin' and a hated rider. Froggy went a courtin' and a hated rider. Froggy went a courtin' and a hated rider.
A ribbit, a ribbit, a ribbit, a ribbit, a ribbit. And all around my hearth, I will wear the green with love. And all around my hearth, for a 12-month and a day. And if anyone should hearth me, the reason why I'm hearthing it, it's all horse, 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 bullets! And it's no nay never.
Horse!
No nay never, no more will I play the wild rover. No never, no more. And it's no nay never.
Horse!
No nay never, no more will I play the wild rover. No never.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
Okay.
Hello. Thank you very much.
Oh. I've arsed me sideburn off. What am I going to do?
I get it.
It's alive.
That's got a little bastard.
Careful, you'll get that old eco-warrior back on here to complain about that.
More trouble, Jed. Don't you worry about that.
Ask. Oh, right, oh.
That must have been some arse.
That was. That was one of my finest arses yet. Off the Richter scale, that one.
Well, there you go, folks. Enjoy the interval now. We'll be on our way. That's thank right. you. Horse!
That's got it. We're off to smoke a couple of rocks.
That's right.
See you later.
You know you should eat your fruit before you eat your meal.
Mm-hmm. Why?
Well, no, that's what they say, just to do with digestion. Well, it works for you, mate, you know.
Traditionally, you eat your fruit after, though, don't you?
No, but you should. I was told by someone who knows about nutrition, because you eat your fruit first. 20 minutes is true, isn't it?
You know a lot.
Well, apparently, know. Yeah, and then you're see? Not... But you're also not supposed to combine vegetables and proteins and all that, you know, blimey.
I shall miss this.
Dear Higson, it's a pleasure to work. When you're comfortable, you can do anything. I think that's a motto. It's worth adopting, isn't it? I'm going to get comfortable and do anything.
Where are we going, by the way? Who am I? The way he's in is there. What's going on?
Where
we got off the bus before we went in
there? I thought we got in this here.
Why would he drop us there?
This is proper Spinal Tap.
Lovely, though, isn't it?
Oh, hello. This is nice.
Proper theatre.
So is it full to the top, Ian?
Microphones. For the use of. Sound check, put them on, try them out. Do they work? Yes, they work. We're free to go. See those noises? That's people talking. This is the venue. Pan round.
You know what I mean? It makes you just want to sing cabaret. My!
All around my bum. For 12 months and a day.
This is Reese, the young Reese Thomas. 10 years from now, you won't even be able to get within 200 foot of him. Literally. Be like Wacko Jacko.
We'll be like
three amigos.
Three amigos.
I'm Martin Short.
So are you friends, family?
I've got nothing on.
Look at that. It's like the Rolling Stones, Ryder, isn't it? Circa 1971. The cocaine's all under there. Lovely. Oh, lovely cocaine. Lovely.
Look at the gums on this boy. That is awful.
Mandingo.
Wait.
That's a good shot. Put that in.
Kill him. Charles, kill him. He's no good to me. Take him away.
Smother him. That's a good shot there. Do you want to shot that? That's a nice the shot. Artist. Look. Look at that.
Reese. Did you drive me for a moment?
Please don't show that.
Oh, no, the image.
Oh, my God. We're now in shock.
I'm eating.
Charlie, you all right?
Yeah, what?
So what's happening?
Well, that's it, you know.
Well, yeah, I know it's the end of the tour, but you said afterwards we'd do a cheesy piece special.
Well, I said we might do a cheesy piece.
No, you said we would.
I didn't say it was definite.
You said we would.
No, you did say that we would do one, Charlie.
I didn't necessarily say it would be with you, though.
Oh. So, what? What about this? You're going to fucking laugh at me.
Oh, sorry, sir. Look, it's... I mean, what can I say? All right.
What you can say is, yes, we'll do a cheesy piece special because you've invested a lot of time in the character and you've had this specially made up and people have had to be paid for this.
No, it's not really a character. You just got to do a bit of dancing. I mean, it's not like...
Yeah, well, that's always been your problem, isn't it? Because you don't really know what proper characters are.
Simon, we...
No!
Very nice to speak to you. Very nice indeed. I'm off. That's you.
It's not what you think. I borrowed it. But, I'll get me coat.
Thank you for coming up to the house. The old place is looking a bit shabby, isn't it? Like a rundown, crumbling Venetian palazzo. Have you seen that film, Ted, Death in Venice?
I don't think so, sir, no.
You should see it. It's marvellous, Ted. It's all about somebody dying in Venice.
There's a clue in the title, sir.
Yes, that's very incisive of you, Ted. There certainly is. But no, I do think we could do with something of a facelift around here. Do you ever watch Changing Rooms, Ted?
Not really, sir, no. Mrs. Ted likes House Invaders, but I'm not interested, sir.
Well, I watch it all the time, Ted. I find it very inspiring. It's all about creative people and practical people working together to build a better world. And it's got Lawrence Llewellyn Byrne in it, Ted. Who really is quite unashamedly flamboyant.
I prefer Handy Andy, sir.
Oh, me too. He has that tool belt, doesn't he, Ted? Marvelous tool belt. He can keep all his tools in it at the same time. It's a terrific invention. I was thinking maybe I could get one for you, Ted. You'd wear it, wouldn't you, Ted? Tell me you'd wear it.
No, sir.
No. It's a far-fetched idea, Ted. You know, in all the excitement, I've quite forgotten what it was I wanted to talk to you about.
Well, if it's about the drainage in the lower field, sir, I think that I finally sorted it out.
Well, that is excellent, Ted. It's excellent news after all these years. It calls for something of a celebration, I think. We should go out together somewhere. Do you like Queen, Ted?
The Queen, sir.
The pop group Queen. It's just I happen to have a couple of tickets for the musical with the music of Queen. We Will Rock You. I was just wondering, do you like musicals, Ted?
Not really, sir. No.
No. Well, you know, I'm sure I can very easily find somebody else to give the tickets to. They're for women, really, aren't they, Ted? Musicals. They're not for men like us. He doesn't hear me. How can I make him understand? Why do I feel so giddy? My whole world is in a spin. I feel so tongue-tied. So near and yet so far from him.
I must get some new boots.
What are these strange feelings inside of me? After all, he's just a man.
I hope I get home in time for Buffy the Vampire Slayer.
Maybe he hears me somewhere inside him. If he would only speak my name.
That's Sarah Michelle Gellar. She's very good.
Oh, my world would be complete if he would only understand. If I could be like him, the good earth upon my hand.
I hope I've got some swore figure in the shed.
That can never be him and me, Ted and I and he.
Why does he look at me that way? Could it be he knows? Surely not, but how can I tell
he
you?
Doesn't
this feeling
hear me.
Deep inside my heart, burning inside
he
me.
Doesn't
I put
know.
The horse before the cart. How can I tell? How can I tell him I haven't really sorted out the drainage?
Okay, I gotta go.
This forthcoming festive season, I'll be mostly having it away in a manger.
Now, recently, I've been having a lot of trouble with cowboys. Not the builders, the real ones. They are murder, aren't they? They're always shooting each other, or shooting Indians. They're covered in dust, and their spurs catch on the skirting. Drives my mum nuts. Now, this cowboy, right, 9 Stone Neddy from Nantucket, he's 26 and he's killed 48 people. He goes into a bar, right, through the louvre doors, 1599 home base. As soon as he goes in there, everyone freezes, don't they? Like that. And at the card tables, they all freeze. And at one table, they're playing Mousetrap. And the ball is still going round the game. And Neddy hears that, because like a deaf person or a really good maths teacher, he's used to complete silence. And he thinks, what's that, right? And he starts to walk over to the table. You know the way cowboys walk, takes him half an hour to get there. But the reason cowboys walk like that is they spend 10 hours a day in the saddle and then during the evening they bot each other. There's nothing wrong with that, but those two disciplines do make for a very slow walk. You know what I mean? So he finally reaches the table and he goes, I can't do the accent. That's a mighty fancy game you got there, boy. And I said to him, yes, Neddy, it's called Mousetrap. The object of the game is to trap a small plastic mouse, look, there he is, under a little upturned plastic laundry basket. And he goes to me, I play a lot of fancy games in my time, boy. I play Kaplunk in Reno. And I play Connect Four in Texas. And I played solitaire on my own. I ain't never played no mousetrap. And I said to him, first of all, that's a double negative, I ain't never. Secondly, I'm trying to have a game here, now piss off, you dusty cunt. Didn't like that. Unpopular decision, that was. Gone for his guns, isn't he? As he's gone for his guns, in that split second, someone shouted, mousetrap. Well, it was a Mexican fella. He's gone, mousetraperanos! And that sort of broke the spell, and Neddy's dropped his guns, and he's burst out crying. You know. And luckily, one of the Mexicans was a trained counsellor. Result, sat him down, he had a right long talk with him, and regressed him back to when he was 10 years old. His dad shot his donkey on his birthday. That was why he was so aggressive, you know? And now he's a much more respectable and valued member of the community. I mean, he ain't happy, but who is? Really? I met this bloke in the street, right? And he goes to me, all right, mate? I said, yeah, I'm all right. And he said, do you know how long you can keep a chicken in the fridge for? It's about 3 days, isn't it? And he went, no, I tried that. On the third day, I opened the door and it was dead.
Shoot you!
Which was nice?
Let's have roll! Hey! I'm at Winchester!
Poor Talbot! Time there, and my third wife was a marsupial. In the end, I had her spayed. I had to. She was reproducing at will. I got on the phone to them and I said quite clearly, and I got that guy like that, money there, and I clicked out and pull! There's only a pull! One chap had his foot blown off. I chuckled out. You should have seen me at the time. I laughed for a week. I I was... Egrets, I've had a few, but then again, too few to mention. They're very difficult to keep. And the women folk ate the monkeys from the tail up. Drove them actually wild. Their king had a magic potato in the shape of Sam Haman's face. And I put the wrong boy in the harness. He went like that, pow! 3 miles down the bloody channel. I mean, I cried as I did. Parents were absolutely mortified. I didn't give a toss. Because, you see, I'm afraid I was very, very drunk.
The Chichester Players proudly present The Lady M by C.K. Hetherington.
Oh, Lady Marchmaine, it can't go on like this.
I know, Butch, it's madness. Clive is bound to find out about us sooner or later. I risk losing everything, Butch.
But blow it all, Lady Marchmaine. You don't need all this. Your huge house, all your money, your jewellery, your 16 horses, your Bentley, your yacht, your...
Well, hold fire. Let's not rush into this.
Run away with me, Lady Marchmaine. Run away. We'll go far away from all this and live a simple life.
No, Clive would make our lives miserable.
Then there's only one way out of this.
No, not that. Anything but that.
Yes, Lady Marchmaine, I'll do it. I'll kill him this moment because I love you. You type of fool.
I can't let you do it. Why, that would be cold-blooded murder.
Are you all right, Lady Marchmaine? I thought I heard some...
Oh, my word. What have we done?
Mildred.
No, it's Clive, my husband.
Mildred. I was in the library reading a book when I thought I heard something. It sounded like a gunshot.
Oh, no. That was just a door slamming.
Darling, I can't find my seat. Oh. I can't find my seat. I'm not pissed, you know, I
can't find my seat. Mildred, it's late. Are you coming to bed, darling?
In a moment. There's something I have to do first.
I can't find my sheath.
Can't one of the servants deal with it? That's what we pay them for. Look, there's Butch, the stable boy. Can't he do it for you?
Oh, Clive, if only you knew.
Oh, shit, it's a play. I can't find my sheath. Carry on. I'm not here.
I'll ring for a maid.
Clive, I've told you, I can do it myself.
It's very good.
Nonsense, darling.
You rang, sir?
Shh, I'm not here.
Yes, there's something my wife wants doing. I wondered if you could do it for her. What is it you need doing, darling?
Clive, how many times do I have to tell you I can do it myself?
Well, I do need to tidy up a bit. Hello, what's this? Oh, it's a dead body!
No, don't worry, it's an actress.
Look, she's trying not to laugh. I'll fuck off.
Oh, my God, it's Polly. She's been shot. Dotty, fetch a mop and bucket. I'm going to call for the police. Hello, is that the police? Yes, it's Lord Marchmain here up at Marchmain House. Yes, I was in the library reading a book when I... Oh, God. Sorry, I just come. I heard a sound. I came rushing down. I found my wife with a stable boy and then... Oh, God. It's happened again. Did you notice that when I shook my leg? It was some lightning. You know what? I've quite forgotten what I was talking about.
You say damn and blast it.
Oh, right, yes. It's all right, I don't think they've
noticed.
When
the lightning happens.
Right. OK, well, to cut a long story short... Damn and blast it.
What is it, darling?
The phone's been cut off. What are we going to do?
Well, listen, why don't you get the Bentley out of the garage, drive down to the gatekeeper's lodge and use the telephone there to phone the police? And meanwhile, I'll see if Butch here can get the generator working again.
We've got to think of something.
I know. Why don't you get the Bentley out of the garage, drive down to the gatekeeper's lodge and use the phone there? In the meantime, I'll see if I can get the generator working.
Good idea.
Hello. Listen, can either of you actually hear me? Would it help if I put a maid's outfit on and got my tits out? That is never going to happen.
Don't stop. It's going very well. I'm going to go and get the police.
I don't think that's a good idea, letting him go to the police.
Well, I had to get rid of him. We have to think of something and think of something fast. The police will be here at any moment now.
Coming soon to a theatre near you, John Actor plays a tough, uncompromising, Agatha Christie-style country cop in Shut It!
Shut It! Right, I'm in charge here. Hercule Monkfish. Morty's dead, Bergerac's on Bravo, and Inspector Frost is just Del Boy with a moustache. I'm going to Cluedo you off, son. I'll make it the stable lad in the front room with the pistol. Right, you, take that rug and piss off. You, go and keep my car seat warm. You, put your knickers on and make me a cup of tea, two sugars. And you, over here, come and help me with my inquiries. And you lot, do one.
Shumaika diez.
Kayocha drus.
Shut the door, Ken.
It's all I know, Kenneth. Oh. Let's go on the prowl, shall we, sir? Ken? Ooh, look at him, Ken. Look.
Oh, look at the state of you, butt. Where have you been all afternoon, sir?
Have you been at a lap dancing establishment?
Have you been to the fantasy lounge?
Mm. Mock and blunt.
Dirty pig. Oh. Do you sometimes find it a little frustrating, sir, being that close to the naked female form?
Makes it a bit difficult getting it home on the bus, doesn't it, sir?
Oh, it's like a tent pole, isn't it, sir? Oh. Time for a lady, Ken.
I'm right behind you, Ken.
I know, you usually are. Hello, madam.
Oh, you're looking a bit... Is it a lady, Kenneth?
Unfeasibly large Adam's apple.
The hairy hands.
The Prince Albert.
The huge bollocks. Let's move on. Hello, madam. You're looking very cheerful. Have you got your rabbit with you?
They've all got them, Ken. They're obsessed with them, their rampant rabbits.
Do you sometimes worry, madam, that men have become marginalised, or do you just think sod it and pop Mr. Rabbit back in his hole? Oh. Does it make that noise, madam? Careful which one you're using. Oh. Do you know, Kenneth, statistically speaking, there should be a lady on her rabbit in this very auditorium, even as we speak, sir.
Oh, I feel quite nautical holding this, Ken.
Ah, varsity blows! Rabbit ahoy! Blimey, Ken, she's frothing at the mouth.
Ooh, suits you, madam.
What do you call your rabbit, madam? Flopsy, Mopsy, Cottontail? Or Tom Jones?
Oh, thank God for Duracell.
But watch out for the myxomatosis.
Suit you.
Suit you.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, at this point in the show, we'd like to open the comedy out to you with an open mic spot. It's absolutely genuine. If anyone out there wants to come and tell a joke, you can. This is your stage. Anyone? This is true. Serious. Come on. Someone. Yes. Anyone.
Yes, me. Oh, the bells, Esmeralda. Oh.
Sir Colin McHunt. Hawkeye the New. Oh, I'm mad I am. Quite insane. Nurse the screens. Say no to the euro. Oh, dear. Oh. Doctor, doctor. Sometimes I feel like a wigwam. Sometimes I feel like a teepee. Well, come back when you're a marquee, because my daughter's getting married. Stop it, Colin, you're too funny. Oh, dear. You know, funny thing happened to me on the way to the theatre. So, yeah, my car broke down. Yeah, it was in absolute floods of tears. Crying its little eyes out, it was only joking. I came by train. Wagon train. It's at one point we were entirely surrounded by Red Indians, members of the Calcutta Communist Party. Yes. They were demanding the overthrow of capitalism and free poppadoms for all. Oh, dear. I'm an alien. Not really. Dr. Pepper, what's the worst that could happen? Right. How about, I tell you what, how about a bit of improv? You shout something out and I'll improvise around it. Right, some impressions then. You know the way Roy Brendan puts on a pair of glasses and suddenly he's someone else. Oh. So, if I say I'm already wearing glasses, so here's some people who wear glasses. You are the weakest link. Goodbye. That's Anne Robinson there. Something of a local hero. Oh, groovy, baby. Oh, behave. Let's shag. Austin Powers there. You was only supposed to blow the bloody doors off. Michael Caine, of course. Hello, I'm Woody Allen. Woody Allen there. Just like that. Oh, I should take the glasses off for that one. Oh, I can't see anything. Stevie Wonder. Say no to the euro. Say no to the euro.
Colin, can you come back to your seat now? I don't think they like you.
Doreen, come on. You know, Doreen, you and me, we should be a double act.
Oh, no, Colin, I'm not funny like you. I can't do all those fantastic jokes. I'm alien.
No, I mean like a proper double act, Doreen. There's something I have to ask you.
Oh, do you want to borrow my car again?
No. I, Colin Hunt, do humbly beseech thee, fair maid Doreen of Leytonstone, wilt thou be my lawful wedded wife? Well, come on, you can hardly say no in front of all these people.
No.
I was only joking, Doreen. No. Of course I was. Colin Hunt, I'll never be tied down by a woman.
No, Colin, of course I'll marry you, just that you can't ask me in front of all these people.
Oh, great. I mean, we can shag and everything.
No, let's just be like a normal married couple and never have sex.
Along the mountain track, and as I go, I love to sing with my knapsack on my back. Valderie, Valdera, Valderie, Valdera, Valderie, Valdera, my knapsack on my back.
There's two on them now.
I love to go wandering along the mountain track.
And are you lost?
Pardon, fellow.
Are you lost here in this dark place? Not sure of the path, needing directions?
No. I'm a fully experienced rambling hiker. And the Lord is always with me.
Oh, he's here and all, is he? Yeah, well, you'm still lost.
No. I'm simply hiking from St. Mellon's to Ely.
Well, you'd be lucky to get out of there alive, stranger.
No. I've alerted people of my whereabouts. I have no fear.
Well, you should have fear, boy. What lives down there is beyond description. Can't you feel them hundreds of eyes out there in the darkness? Eh? Watching your every move. Danger lurks round every corner. Wild dogs, ravens, owls.
I have no fear of dogs or owls. I laugh at your tales, old man. Look, I have with me my trusty horn or hooter. One blast on this and any belligerent dog or owl is rendered immobile.
Yeah, well, what about slithering things? I'm often very hard of hearing, I'm slithering things.
But I don't know.
That wouldn't stop them, would it, eh?
Well, I don't
I wouldn't
know.
Stop giant deaf owls, eh? Or eels, great slithering eels with wings. I'm land octopuses, sea bats. Shark dogs, hairy snakes, airborne crayfish!
G'day, and welcome to That's Amazing with me, Carl Hooper. Well, later on the show, we've got a guy from Sydney who's never farted. We meet a man from Adelaide who hates the Japanese. Is that right? And all the way from Alice Springs, little Mary Ann Louise, 8 years old, she still believes in Jesus Christ our Lord. Isn't that the sweetest thing? But first up on the show, I've got something truly amazing. A woman. I've never had one of those before. Well, not on my show anyway. So let's meet Professor Jan Porter. Yeah, that's right. You heard me correctly. Professor Jan Porter. Not only is she a Sheila, but she's a professor as well. And that is truly amazing. Well, what do you got for me, Prof? Perhaps you baked a cake. Now, you've got some little biscuits with faces on. Nope, you've knitted me a sweater with a very complicated pattern.
I would like to point out that I am, in fact, the most highly qualified archaeologist in my field.
And surprise, surprise, you got no sense of humour. Now, Ms. Porter, you're a woman, you're a scientist, you look like a bloke. Are you perhaps a rusty bike?
I am a lesbian, as a matter of fact, and I am proud of it. My sexuality is at the very core of my work. I am currently researching ancient matriarchal societies in the Southern Hemisphere. To wit, I have the largest collection of totemic fetish objects in the entire world, each one of them representing in their own individual way the female clitoris. I frequently masturbate while I'm working, and I use the power of my orgasm to unleash the secrets of the past.
You can't say that. Jesus. Will you pack up your flaming genitalia and get off my show?
Mr. Hooper, calm down. I can assure you I've studied your type a great deal, and all that's happening is you're displaying the classic male fear of the awesome power that is the female clitoris.
Now, you listen to me, darling. I've never touched a clitoris in my life. And I'm not about to start with yours. Now, get off my show.
OK, I will get off your show. It's crap anyway. But I want to say this. You are a textbook example of the female-loathing, latent homosexual Neanderthal man.
That's what being Australian's all about. Welcome to the land of wonder.
Fire-breathing trout! Hey, Daddy Longlegs! I'm thinking, where's the secret door? Hey, that's my only hope. Where's the secret door? Well, let me tell you, boy, there ain't no secret door!
I'm just going to leave that. Now, my next guest comes deep from the heart of Czechoslovakia. Please welcome onto this stage Prince Alfonso. Give it up. Come on. Give it up. Good to see you, Prince. How was your trip?
Smooth, Carl. Smooth.
Okay, baby. Now, what are you going to do for us tonight?
I can do anything, Carl.
Fair play to you, but... What are you going to do for us tonight on the show that is truly amazing?
Tonight, Carl, I am going to do animal sounds. Name any animal in the animal kingdom, and I will do the animal sound here with my mouth. Carl.
All right, a snake. Get off my show. Get off my show.
I can do a robin, Carl.
A what?
A little robin redbreast.
What's that?
He's a tiny little Christmas bird, Carl.
Okay, mate, go ahead, do your tiny Christmas bird and be quick about it, please.
I can't. Carl?
What?
Will you lend me some money?
I'm afraid not, mate. Now get off my show, you twisted gypsy. Next week on the show, we speak to a man named Lenny Page who claims to have been a popular entertainer in the 1970s. Good night.
Coming soon from Pierce Films. Relentless bone-crunching action. It just doesn't stop. It keeps going. There is no let-up. It goes on and on and on. Then on some more. Unstoppable. Relentless. It's the long, big punch of seven.
Ah!
Yeah! I was rummaging around looking for the last of John Major's gallstones when I heard this tap, the window, the operating theatre. I looked up and there was Edwina Curry, wearing high heels, stockings, suspenders and a basque. Which is nice.
Mattinato Don Giannai. Presentarios mio contessera ton unique disco rock opera. Strog. Ton fabulare navitosmos, mospros cosmos corpus Christi, university challenge. Bowing ding dong dong. Musico, rock and disco ton Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Scripto ton Ben Elton. Fantastico shit. Hoopla, Sprog!
Sheep, 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 sheep shaga.
Sheep, 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 sheep.
Sheep, 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 sheep.
Ship, crocodile.
Crocodile?
No, me a choco. Choco.
Ship.
Archangel Gabriel, it's a joke, oh.
No, Archangel Gabriel, like.
Regarda Constella, ambush shepherds, Illuminatus, Don Crispy, son of God, Holy Sprog, Jesus Christ.
Questa mia pussycat.
Nu è arrivato in a pesses.
Lehem. Oh, ton innkeeper bastardo, me regarde ton shitty stable.
Oh, mio achy breaky back.
Reclinato opton manger.
Oh. Oh!
Pusho!
Oh,
Pusho!
Oh! Blimey!
Who's that then? The Son of God? The Messiah?
Fuck me, Mary, you're talking mule!
I'll tell you what, that's the hardest game in the world, that is.
Harry Magi!
Nusso trio kingly weirdos. Studio. Golden Nuggets.
Frankincense.
Oh, well, it's the thought that counts.
Me? The 13th king of Abyssinia, here. In a stable with a virgin and a mule with a tube of myrrh. With my reputation, are they quite mad? Oh well, here's to the second coming.
Thank you.
Well, hey! Thank you very much.
But if we wanted to do something, we could do a Christmas special, say? We could just do a one-off.
Yeah,
just
do a one-off.
Yeah, we could. Yeah, we could do it, yeah. BBC Three will have us.
BBC Three will have anyone.
So you mean it's no indication
it's
of our success?
And we've got we are now anyone. That's what you've got to remember. We are now anyone.
But we'll have
not
to,
someone.
We'll have to come up with some new characters, don't you think?
We never did Limping Man. He was good, remember him?
Give him a pipe, he might work.
Oh, yeah, Limping Man with a pipe.
We've never done anyone with a pipe. Maybe I should have a pipe.
Pipe was my idea, Tom. Yeah, maybe the pipe was your idea, but the limp was my idea.
I want to be to you. Keep up with more enthusiasm, please. And action.
The limp was my idea!